Hey, SmartPak fans. Welcome to a special edition of Ask the Vet. You may notice I'm sitting on this side, not that side. I'm Dr. Lydia Gray, the Staff Veterinarian and Medical Director at SmartPak. This is Nerida Richards, PhD. I'm going to let you introduce yourself.
Sure. Thanks, Lydia. So I'm Nerida. I'm an equine nutritionist from Australia, which is probably quite obvious given my accent.
I was going to say far.
Yeah.
Obvious. True.
I work as a consulting nutritionist in Australia. I formulate feeds and supplements for companies all over the world. And I also run the feedxl.com website, which is a nutrition calculator that horse owners use to put their horses' diets together.
We love it. Yeah. Great. We ask you to submit your horse nutrition questions specifically, and then this segment will answer one of those questions. You'll answer one of those questions. Mm-hmm. I'm helping. And then to see the other questions, just click on the playlist at the end of the video, and you get to see them all. So, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Ready.
The next question is from Instagram, and it's sdoran21, and it says, tips for getting an easy keeper, a mini, to lose weight, in addition to using a grazing muzzle. So they've already using one technique.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Again, expert in this because my horses are easy keepers. And it's tough. You know, I was thinking when I was flying on this trip that I think one of the hardest things about managing easy keepers is the emotional aspect.
You're exactly right. You feel bad. You feel like
you're
being mean.
I know. And you just want them to be out and not muzzled and not locked up and not restricted. And it's tough, you know. Yeah. It really, like, I find it really tough. And some days I'll go, you know what, just have a day out on the pasture, which I shouldn't, but it's tough. So there was some research that's been really recently published from the University of Melbourne in Australia that showed they looked at just calorie restriction, and then they looked at calorie restriction plus exercise.
Okay.
And exercise is the thing that makes all the difference.
Ah.
So you can get partway there just with calorie restriction, but you know, I know with my horses, our pastures are largely Australian native grasses, which typically very low protein, like 5-6% when they're mature, and really low calorie content.
Okay.
My horses are on them muzzled over summer, and you know, muzzle 23 hours of the day apart from when they come into. So just restricting calorie intake is sometimes quite difficult to get to get weight off.
Yeah.
So you need to increase their calorie requirement somehow without increasing their calorie intake.
Right.
So exercise is.
All right. And when you say exercise, what do you mean?
Well, I have to go and read the paper again, but I'm pretty sure it wasn't a lot of exercise. So these guys were doing sort of 15 minutes of walk and trot a day. So you know, it's not a lot, and with a mini horse, you know, I mean, that take it if you walk, if you're a walker, you know, take it with you.
Minis, at least in this country, we drive them.
Oh yeah.
So I think that would be really good exercise.
Yeah. But if you know, if you don't have the time to tack it up and do that, then take it for a walk. The other thing that I find infinitely useful, and thankfully it rolls around once a year for 3 months, is winter. Because it increases their calorie requirement. So I look at my horses.
The cold.
Yeah. I mean, they're warm-blooded animals. They need to maintain their body temperature. And the only way they can do that is by burning calories. Mm-hmm. So over summers when it's quite warm, they don't need a lot of their maintenance energy requirements. So just to maintain their body weight is really low because they're not burning much up to stay warm. If you can let them get a bit cold, and I'm not saying leave them absolutely miserable in wet snow, we don't have snow where I'm from, but you know, don't leave them miserable, but resist the temptation to dress them up and keep them, you know, to have them warm in lots of rugs and stuff. They're comfortable down to about minus 15 Celsius, which you may have to put on.
I think that what
it's
I've looked
well
at...
well below freezing.
Yeah, depending on where you are, it can be anywhere from 25 degrees Fahrenheit to 5 degrees Fahrenheit, which is just above, well below freezing.
Yeah.
Let's
agree
that, well below freezing.
Well below freezing. And they're comfortable as long as they're dry.
Yeah.
And then if they're wet, it goes for us 30 degrees Celsius above that to their comfortable temperature. It was raining at our place, a rare occurrence, the other day, and it was warm. Like, we could have been outside in a t-shirt, and my little mare was shivering because she was wet.
Yeah.
Which I was going, burning calories.
Burning calories.
But you know, if it was like, it was short term rain, if it rains for days, sure. I'll throw a rug on my horses. But yeah, it really is like, don't be afraid to let them feel mm-hmm. some cold and mm-hmm. to actually burn some calories mm-hmm. off over winter to lose a bit of weight. And it's a natural cycle of what horses are.
Exercise
is where the key.
I have told people if you can exercise twice a day, mm-hmm. like some in the morning and some in the afternoon. Maybe it's you get a kid from school to come and walk your horse or whatever, but you know, you ride in the morning and the kid walks in the afternoon, whatever, but sometimes twice a day is
just
really helpful.
Just making them move. I really would love a dog that is trained to keep my horses moving. Someone needs to do this.
Yeah.
It's just some sort of a herding dog that goes, okay, mm-hmm. you've eaten enough there for a bit, move along, so mm-hmm. they just move. You know, people come up with all sorts of clever ways of making the distance to get back to water mm-hmm. a lot.
Like the water's here and the food is here.
Yeah, and then they'll do, you know, in Shrek, when the guy has to run through the... it's like being an airport security mm-hmm. line, and you have to walk backwards and forwards. So instead of walking in a straight line, mm-hmm. you have to zigzag mm-hmm. back.
There's one device, tell me if you've seen this. It's a hay feeder, and it's on a timer, and it allows the horse access to the hay, let's say, for 20 minutes, and then it closes.
Oh.
And the other side opens, but the horse has to walk through to get to it.
Yeah, yeah.
So the horse has to, he can't stand in one place and eat all day.
Oh,
he has to
clever.
Move to access the hay again.
You know, something like that, even that just opened for 20 minutes in every hour. So slow feeder, but just giving them access to hay for 20 minutes in every hour, and then, you know, like...
Go do something else for the
rest of
the
time. Enough, it's enough chewing and salivation, because mm-hmm. one of the biggest problems with managing these guys is just the worry of gastric ulcers from having an
Correct.
Empty stomach all the time.
Yeah.
So, you know, the longer you can draw out the amount of feed they can have in mm-hmm. a day, the better. And something mm-hmm. like that would be... awesome.
I think we've discovered the solution here.
Yeah. Someone build it now, please. And then send it to Australia for me.